Breastman is at the end of the Tsunami and Cartoon Network is celebrating.
In the year 1999, high above Macross Island in the South Pacific, a phenomenal event occurred in the skies which altered the course of human history. A gigantic alien spaceship broke through the very fabric of hyperspace on a collision course with the Earth. During its uncontrolled fall from the sky, the plummeting space fortress produced shockwaves of incredible force. The craft measured nearly 3/4 of a mile in length. There was no sign of the alien crew. The armored hull had taken the brunt of the damage, leaving much of the sophisticated technosystems intact. What remained of the giant battle fortress gave evidence of a civilization that was light years ahead of Earth's most advanced thinking. Global war ravaged the Earth at that time, but even this devastation paled by comparison to the threat of invasion from outer space. A ceasefire was ordered, and world leaders banded together to form a united Earth government. Under the new government, the world's most brilliant minds formed a research team to study and restore the alien space fortress. Deciphering parts of documents found on board, they labored to unravel the secrets of an incredibly complex technology called Robotech. Convinced that the scientists had solved this complex riddle, world leaders ordered a celebration. For 10 years, the total resources of an entire planet had been focused on the restoration of the space fortress. A great city had grown up around the Robotech project, and today, on the eve of the ship's maiden flight, every citizen, man, woman, and child, was gathering to celebrate their achievement and to witness the launching of their planet's new defender.
It's the big shots making their grand entrance.
Captain Lovell doesn't seem too happy about it.
Don't look so sour, Captain Glover. It's our big day. Surely you realize all those loyal citizens out there consider you their hero. I think you could at least wave to them.
All right, I'll wave.
The countdown has begun. On board the giant spaceship, the crew of raw recruits, freshly graduated from the Robotech Academy, is busy with the pre-launch checklist.
All manual systems are our green light.
I'll now feed you the computer projection.
The ceremony starts in 15 minutes. I hope the captain gets here in time. I hear he didn't get much sleep last night.
Yeah, the other officers threw a farewell party for him. They probably sat up all night telling each other war stories. You know how they are.
And where were you, Claudia?
What are you talking about, Lisa?
You didn't come in until 4 this morning. You must have been partying, too.
You jealous? I had a late dinner with Commander Foker.
Claudia!
What?
You stayed out all night knowing you both had flight duty today.
So, what's the big fuss about, Lisa? We won't let it affect the performance of our duty. After all, we're not children and you're not our mother.
Your responsibilities to the ship come first, Claudia.
But my private life is my business. Nobody else's. Now then, let's get to work, all right? Get out of here.
Lisa doesn't understand about men, Claudia. She's in love with this spaceship.
Yeah, you got that right.
Oh, don't argue.
I'm not the one who keeps butting into everybody's business.
I'm warning you.
I hate to interrupt, but hadn't you better check your monitor, Commander?
It's an unidentified incoming aircraft, Lisa.
Attention aircraft approaching on course 107.
Please identify yourself. Please identify yourself.
This is Rick Hunter, invitation number 201.
That's confirmed as an invitation from Lieutenant Commander Foker. Follow course 57 for landing.
Roger.
And now we present a display of aerial acrobatics demonstrating the amazing advances we have made through robotechnology. Lieutenant Commander Roy Foker, leader of the Veritech Fighter Squadron, will describe the action for us.
Today, you'll see how we've applied human know-how to a complex alien technology. Keep your eyes on planes 2 and 4. Flying at speeds of 800 miles per hour, only 50 feet above the ground, they will pass within just a few yards of one another. Robotechnology makes such precision possible.
Huh?
Oh, no! Rick! Is that you, Rick Hunter?
Roy! It's good to hear your voice, old buddy. I understand you're a lieutenant commander now.
Are you crazy? Get that junk heap out of here! Hunter, when I get my hands on you, I'm gonna...
Hey, Ed, switch this to radio only, will ya?
What are you trying to do, buddy? Make a perfect fool of me?
Nobody's perfect, Commander.
You haven't changed a bit, have you? Well, this isn't your dad's amateur flying circus.
My men are real pilots.
I'm gonna have to make you eat those words, Commander. Coming in.
Stop clowning around. Look out!
Get out of there!
Hi, Roy.
Just who do you think you are? What were you trying to do? Get yourself killed?
Hey, calm down.
And while we're at it, where'd you learn to do that anyway?
It was just a simple booster climb. You taught me that yourself when I was just a kid. Hey, I have to admit those guys are pretty good. Not as good as me, of course.
You don't have to brag to me, Rick. I know all about your winning the amateur flying competition last year.
Actually, I've won it 8 years in a row. What have you been doing?
I was busy fighting a war. I guess you didn't read about my having shot down 108 enemy planes.
You're proud of being a killer?
What? There was a war on and I was a soldier. I just did my duty.
You promised my dad that as soon as the war was over, you'd come back to the air circus. Why did you go back on that promise, Roy?
I really felt guilty about letting your father down. Only, this Robotech thing is so exciting, I just couldn't give it up. It just gets in your blood or something. I don't know.
What is Robotech, anyway? Just more modern war machinery. And the aliens, huh?
Jason,
I've
already had a
car.
Can't have any more.
What?
No, Jason. Cancel the order, please.
Oh, you'll get sick.
I don't care.
That's it. We're going home.
I want to call
him. Come on, Jason. I don't want to see anything.
Huh? Well, Roy, I see you're still a big ladies' man.
Hey,
Blasting through a warp fold in deep space, a gigantic alien spaceship enters Earth's solar system in pursuit of the damaged Robotech vessel, which has eluded capture by slipping through the time-space continuum. The command ship leads a vast armada of battle vessels manned by the Zentradi, a race of warriors bred for thousands of generations for the sole purpose of military conquest.
The finder beam has locked on this planet. Are you sure this is where the transmission was coming from?
Yes, sir. I'm positive.
They could have executed a refold.
It's doubtful, sir. There was no evidence of a second drop into hyperspace.
They couldn't have gone far in their condition. They would have to have landed in order to repair the ship. That's a logical speculation, I think.
I agree. It would seem very likely, sir.
Send a scout team.
This fighter's a real beauty, all right. It looks great, but how does it handle?
Well, why don't you just climb aboard and see for yourself?
You mean that?
Sure, I'll go along and ride piggyback behind you. The controls may look pretty complicated, but I'll check you out on them.
I'm not worried. If you can learn to fly one of these things, I can.
Don't be so modest.
This is a day that we've all been looking forward to for 10 years. The Robotech project has been a tremendous asset to the economy of Macross City.
Excuse me, sir. Urgent message from the space monitoring station. A strange flash of light and an explosion followed by irregularities in the gravitational field.
The same sort of thing happened 10 years ago. You know what happened then, don't you?
That's when the alien ship arrived.
Better check it out.
Endangered animal? You. They groom? You groom. They wash? You wash. And when you wash, you can help save them. New Johnson's Endangered Species Shampoos and Soaps. Part of every sale goes to World Wildlife Fund to help save the Earth. They're made with mild stuff, too, and come with cool 3D collector cards. So, you drive your parents crazy, so do they. New Johnson's Endangered Species.
Fall into the gap.
You can't have great style if you've got damaged ends. The Vidal Sassoon Academy has news you can use. If your hair is thinner at the ends, you're losing protein. Vidal Sassoon shampoos and conditioners are a start to perfect ends with a protein moisturizer formula that's absorbed all the way to the ends to keep your style looking great. End of story.
I love happy endings.
Sassoon hair. Style that's perfectly you.
Tough luck, Teddy. Move over, Rover. Buzz off, Bubba. RC cars from Radio Shack. 24 hot models ready to test drive. Anything else is just a toy. Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers. Batteries not included.
Today at 5, Toonami gives you more power.
That kid's gonna be stronger than ours.
I can do it.
Here, to fight.
Dragon Ball Z. Today at 5, come by and watch the fireworks.
Your wish has been granted.
Full on, only Toonami.
The world is baffled as no one can describe what makes the Butterfinger bar delicious.
I thought this was going to be an easy question.
Did they take these special orange cows from France?
Meanwhile, scientists search for answers.
Cross-reference with everything in the known universe? Nothing like it. I knew it.
Will we ever know the secret behind the unique, delicious taste of the Butterfinger?
I mean, why are you asking me these questions? I just drive that truck.
Butterfinger from Nestle. Mysteriously irresistible.
1999, a phenomenal event occurred in the skies
back to Robotech.
Every system aboard the ship is starting up. The defense system is activating the main guns to fire. Shut down all systems. It doesn't work. Captain, the main guns are preparing to fire. I can't control them. What do we do?
Look at that! Now we know for sure that the ship is on that planet. All ships continue advancing and exercise extreme caution.
We have control now. What happened, sir?
Those fireworks about?
I don't know. I better go check. Wait here. I'll see what's going on.
The space monitor report is coming in. It shows what our guns were firing at.
I have it here, Sammy. Two large objects, probably spaceships, in lunar orbit 200,000 miles out. Both objects were struck dead center by the beam and were disintegrated. Huh?
Captain, what is it? What are you laughing about?
It was so obvious! We should have known. A booby trap, of course.
Booby trap, sir?
Yes, it's one of the oldest tricks in military history. A retreating enemy leaves behind hidden explosives and such. The aliens who abandoned the ship armed it with an automatic defense system designed to detect and destroy their enemies. The activation of the guns means that unfriendly forces have approached close enough to be a threat to us. Yes, what is it, Sammy?
No smoking on the bridge. It's against regulations, sir.
I was just holding it. I wasn't going to light it. Scramble all the fighters and prepare for combat.
Enemy forces approaching in sector 412.
On bearing 90, commence firing.
Heavy resistance, sir.
Yes. But why are they using such primitive weapons? Our scout ships have broken through. It's unbelievable. Some sort of trick, no doubt.
Yes, it is puzzling.
It makes no sense.
There has to be a reason, but it's beyond me. Surely the Robotech masters...
Commander Breton, the two enemy space cruisers are approaching. They may be the ones who launched the missile bombardment.
Blast them to bits. Those idiots behave as though they don't even know how to use their own weapons. Full barrage, all cannons.
This is Opera 10 Space Cruiser calling SDF-1. Come in, SDF-1.
Armor 2 is destroyed and Armor 10 is heavily damaged, sir.
I had hoped this moment wouldn't come in my lifetime. After we finally achieved peace on our planet, now we face annihilation by alien forces whose power is beyond our imagination. I had hoped that war was a thing of the past. But here we go again.
All right, move out.
Yes, sir. All forces, move out. We are under attack by alien invaders in Sector 412. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill. All forces proceed at once in battle formation.
Well, boys, you heard her. This is the real thing.
Wolf team has cleared. Skull team, prepare for takeoff.
Skull team ready. All right, men, this is it. Let's go!
What a disorderly arrangement. These people are completely ignorant of space war tactics. What? That's Zor's battle fortress, but what's happened to it?
It appears to have been completely remodeled. Perhaps by the inhabitants of that planet.
Mere Micronians couldn't possibly have captured a Robotech ship.
Maybe it crashed on their planet and they managed to salvage it.
What about the crew? They wouldn't just let them have it.
Maybe they were killed in the crash.
Even so, the ship would have been seriously damaged and these primitives wouldn't have the technology to repair it.
Oh, I know, sir. But is there any other explanation? It is a Robotech vessel. We know they have
reflex weaponry.
Precisely, and this makes them very dangerous, so we must exercise caution.
Target pinpointed, Commander. We are launching fighters.
One Control, calling VF-102. You there on the exhibition grounds were on combat alert. Why haven't you taken off?
You don't mean me, do you? Hey, what? Huh? Hey.
Don't waste any more time. Take off immediately and join the fighter squadron.
What do you mean take off? The runway is demolished.
Runway 2 is clear. You're fully armed and your jets are overheating, so prepare for immediate takeoff.
All set, sir. Good hunting.
Well, okay, if you insist. Telling me what's going on around here?
Who's that? Rick, how's it feel to be a fighter pilot?
Hey, what are you talking about, big brother? I'm not a fighter pilot. Oh!
Rick! Hang on, Rick, I'm coming.
You weren't hit, it was just a close one. You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Don't worry. Combat flying's scary for everybody when they first begin.
You'll be all right, though. You'll find it's not that much different from the good old days with the flying circus.
Yeah, but I never got shot at the circus, Roy.
You'll get used to it. Just tag along behind me for a while, if you can keep up with me.
If I can, I'll do my best not to leave you behind.
That's the spirit. Let's go get him, little brother.
I think I've had it, Roy. I'm getting no response from the controls at all. Oh.
This is SDF-1 Control calling VF-102. Pull out. You're diving right at us.
Tell me something I don't know. I can't pull out. All the controls have lost their power.
Have you tried switching to configuration B?
B? What's that mean?
You don't know? Impossible. All right, listen. Pull down the control mark B on the left side of your console.
Okay, I found it. What's it doing?
Day without air conditioning.
Says tomorrow's gonna be hotter.
Hotter?
Like yesterday.
Yesterday? Yesterday you said you'd call Sears.
I'll call today.
You call now.
I'll call now.
Now's the time to save on Sears installed central air conditioning. Get 0% finance charge, no billing, and no payments until August with the Sears Charge Home Improvement Plan. Call now for a free in-home estimate on a Kenmore air conditioning system. State-of-the-art engineering means greater energy efficiency. A new Kenmore could save 10 to 44% on your annual cooling costs. In time, even pay for itself. Sears also offers fast emergency installation, a 5-year warranty on parts and labor, plus our satisfaction guarantee. And you know Sears will be there to back it up. Get 0% finance charge, no billing, no payments until August. Offer ends May 31st, so call now and save with Sears.
So what's the paper say about tomorrow?
Another scorcher.
Cool.
Cartoon City, home to many mysteries, but none too tough for the Mysteries 18 to solve. With crime crackers like Jabberjaw, Funky Phantom, and Hong Kong Phooey, just to name a few. There's even your own mysteries to solve. Yep, it's no secret. The place to go for a good mystery is Mysteries, Inc. Sunday at 6 on Cartoon Network. Brought to you by Scooby-Doo Goes Hollywood.
Scooby-Doo!
Now on sale from Warner Home Video. Buy one and get a free Scooby comic book.
I'm Ron, lightning your eye to the weather sky.
He can always see a storm coming.
Looks like I'm thinking rain.
So of course I can see why kids gush over Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
It blows them away.
Wrong forecast, Thelma Hare. It's the swirls of cinnamon sugar shining over every bite. A bright part of this complete breakfast.
I see.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch, the taste you can see.
You can collect Fashion Avenue Barbie figurines or special edition Hot Wheels cars. One car or figurine with two fruits from specially marked boxes.
You can't have great style if you've got damaged ends. The Vidal Sassoon Academy has news you can use. If your hair is thinner at the ends, you're losing protein. Vidal Sassoon shampoos and conditioners are a start to perfect ends with a protein moisturizer formula that's absorbed all the way to the ends to keep your style looking great. End of story.
I love happy endings.
Sassoon hair. Style that's perfectly you.
You can play out your own adventures with your virtual friends inspired by Disney's Toy Story.
Your mission, help Buzz Lightyear care for his intergalactic friends.
The alien avoided the evil claw this time.
Cool, check this gate mode.
To infinity and beyond.
Mission control, I'm feeding my alien pizza.
UFO approaching, fire missiles.
Commander Jones, status report.
My alien dog needs exercise, sir.
Disney's Toy Story virtual friends with new pause feature. Each sold separately, batteries included from ThinkWorld.
And now a little rhyme about my brother, by Diddy. My brother Dexter is so lame, always bragging about his brain.
That doesn't rhyme.
Does too. Where was I? Oh, yeah. He makes these machines that are very impressive. If you ask me, he's just a wee bit obsessive.
Diddy.
And when I pick the lock on his stupid old Dory, he screams, Diddy, get out of my laboratory.
Diddy, get out of my laboratory.
see.
Dexter's Lab, tonight at 8 on Cartoon Network.
Cartoon, cartoon!
On the next Real Adventures of Johnny Quest. Burning Wheel. Next time on The Real Adventures of Johnny Quest.
You are experiencing the new and improved Toonami programming format. More action, fewer commercial interruptions. Toonami, building you a better cartoon show, only on Cartoon Network. Thank you very much.
It tried to swat me like a bug.
A distant primitive jungle planet of Quasar. Time 1,000 years in the future. A massive iceberg melting fast in the tropical sun moves steadily towards a jungle beach. There is an evil danger working within this icy prison, a danger so great that even the combined power of the mighty Herculoids may not be able to stop it.
Now, Dorno, while I occupy your angry friend.
No, Father. I will fight at your side.
No, Dorno. You... Come, Dorno. Your friend is not in a playful mood. I know you are anxious, Dorno, but manhood does not happen in a single day.
I know, but... Father, what's wrong?
I hear the sound of machinery. Dorno, come.
An iceberg! How did it get here? The IC is 5,000 miles away.
I do not know, Dorno, but it is this outline of a giant that disturbs me.
Father, look! It is a giant, Father.
And it's headed for our home. Tara may be in danger. Come, Dorno.
Such an old grouch, Tundro. They were just playing. Oh, thank you, Igu. Who are you? What do you want here? Us. He seems indestructible, Xandor.
Xandor, listen! He's coming!
He will hide until we know how to stop this robot. Come, our jungle cave will shelter us. Hans, silence now. There is only one way to stop the robot. We must get inside and deactivate it.
But how, Father?
I have seen this type of warrior robot before. There is a small repair panel in his back, large enough for you and Gleet to climb through, Dorno. We will keep it busy.
Xandor, are you sure?
It is our only chance, Tara, or the robot will destroy us. It will take great courage, Dorno. Are you ready?
Yes, Father.
Now, here goes! Roar!
He's down! Let's go, Gleep! There's the repair panel, Gleep.
Tundro, Zuck, hold your fire. Gorno and Gleep are inside.
Now, all we have to do is find the control center. The problem is, where do we start? Come on, we won't find it standing here. This must be it, Gleep. The Master Control Center. Help me turn off these switches, Gleep. That's the only way we'll find the right one.
They've been in there a long time, Xandor.
Look, the robot moves slower.
Xandor, it's moving towards the cliff.
Herculoids!
That's it, Gleep. Come on.
To the robot, Zock. Quickly. We've got to save Dorno and Gleep.
There they are!
Tara, grab Gleep. I'll get Dorno.
Don't worry, Gleep. Here comes Xandor and Tara.
Warrior robot will bother us no more. Well done, Dorno. You are fast becoming a man.
Many more experiences like that, and I'll fast become an old man.
I think this is where we came in, Dorno. Let's go home, Zock.
Less talk and more action. Your powerful
Toonami will return in a moment. It's time you and I had a talk about the facts of life.
Belt up, gang. We're about to land. Belt up, gang. We're about to land. Belt up, gang. We're about to land. Belt up, gang. We're about to land.
Reruns suck, but there's no escape.
I'm getting out of here.
Get out of there.
Got to get out of here and fast.
You two get out of here.
Let's get out of here.
We have to get out of here.
Welcome to the television business.
My mind is being overwhelmed by terrible feelings.
If anybody knows reruns, it's us. Not because we want to do it that way, but sometimes you have to.
For the benefit of mankind.
Lies, lies!
You can't make a new cartoon every day.
Lies,
lies! So you're destined to fall behind and show one more and once.
And another.
Amazing.
Amazing.
Frightening, too.
And frightening, I might add.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go, Robert.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I don't like it.
Neither do I.
We're sorry about that. I know you guys get burned sometimes.
We have to do something.
I'm with you.
Don't judge us too harshly.
Hang on.
Hold on.
I mean, after all, we're doing this for you.
I suspect Medea is behind this.
Have no fear. Plans are in place to secure the future.
Gracias, amigo.
Oh, nada.
There's new cartoons on the horizon and new stuff's flowing down the pipes.
Were you there? Did you see it?
99's gonna be a party.
How good.
Hang out.
How disappointing.
Well,
they didn't make it very far at all.
Now your child can visit steamy jungles, grassy plains, and the dark depths of the oceans to meet and learn surprising facts about the magnificent animals that live there, all through the captivating, colorful pages of Zoo Books, the publication especially created for young readers. Each monthly issue of Zoo Books is packed with breathtaking full-color photos and scientifically accurate illustrations, plus games and puzzles. Today, through this exclusive TV offer, you can get 12 fascinating issues of Zoo Books for the special price of $19.95. When you call and use your credit card, we'll include the elephants issue as a gift. Plus, you'll also get the colorful collection of animal stickers and the tiger poster. So order Zoo Books today and send learning and fun to a child you love.
To order 12 fascinating issues of Zoo Books for $19.95, call 1-800-441-2400. When you call, we'll include the bonus elephant issue, stickers, and tiger poster with your order. Call 1-800-441-2400. You must be 18 years or older to call.
Hey kids, Hard Hat Harry's back in a brand new video adventure. It's the fantastic real-life farm adventure for kids video. Join Hard Hat Harry and his friends on a fun-filled farm adventure to find out where fruits and veggies come from. Farming is a big job, and you'll see 30 big machines that farmers use to get the job done. See tough tractors with tremendous tires and colossal combines harvesting wheat and corn. Get things growing with amazing seed drills and even a manure spreader.
Yuck!
Wait till you see the nutty way they harvest nuts. Wake up, Mr. Squirrel. Best of all, kids will have foot-stomping fun down on the farm. Real-life farm adventure for kids, originally sold for $19.95, is now $4.95 through the special TV offer. When you call, we'll also tell you about our free bonus video offer, the award-winning real-life giant construction equipment for kids. To order, you must be 18 years or older. Call the number on your screen.
Right now, people all over the world, in 79 countries on 5 continents, are watching an eraser about a duck. Cartoon Network, making the world a better place, one cartoon at a time.
What's up, guys?
Ron, all their airplane went in there.
With him.
Then let me give you a hand.
McNuggets to rescue!
Human Nuggets are brave.
Yo, we're chicken!
Yeah, buddy.
Can I fight?
Is there a movie?
Ronald the dog!
We're coming in. Uh-oh. Roger. That's not Roger. That's Ronald!
You did it, Ronald!
Now that deserves a first-class meal.
Here's my luggage. This baggage claim.
Chips Ahoy!
Greetings, cartoon fans. Daffy Duck here, telling you that you could be the biggest cartoon star to hit the big screen since, well, since me. I'm talking about the Get Toon Sweepstakes. Yep, that's right, a sweepstakes where you, the viewer, actually get tuned. Listen, bub, you're an average Joe, but if you win, you'll become a cartoon star. You and your family will be flown to Hollywood, stay at a luxurious hotel, tour the Warner Brothers lot, spend a day at Six Flags, and star in your own cartoon on Cartoon Network. Wait a minute. You're gonna be a bigger star than me. Who's big ideas?
For your chance to star in your own cartoon, send in a postcard with your name, address, age, and phone number to the Get Toon Sweepstakes, P.O. Box 7555, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. Or stop by your participating grocery store for an official entry form. 100 other winners will get their very own cartoon masterpiece portrait. Brought to you by Kraft Singles and Cartoon Network.
So what are you waiting for? Get toon! Sure, being a cartoon has its drawbacks, but hey, nobody said show business was easy.
I am Weasel,
with a little sonnet.
I'll make bonnet better than Rizal. I am baboon, my butt is red. I can't get no so far ahead. Whenever I have job that's big, Rizal take away and get all credit for himself.
Trouble rhyming, eh? Let's see if this helps. Like an artist before his easel, baboon is happiest without weasel. No need to thank me.
I am Weasel, tonight on Cartoon Network.
Hey there, I'm Chicken, and the network told me to tell you about my new show, Cow and Chicken. So, this is me. Here's my ma and dad, and this is my big stupid sister Cow.
Okay, that about covers it. Let's rock.
Cow and Chicken, tonight at 8 on Cartoon Network.
My cousin, Boomers.
Get ready for a power trip.
We're not here to bow down to your demands. We're here to fight. Bring it on! Hey,
previously on Dragon Ball Z, after exchanging goodbyes, Gohan, Krillin, and Bulma set a course for planet Namek, but their journey was interrupted by an ambush of automated space drones, which relentlessly fired upon them and forced retaliation, sending them careening into a well-camouflaged spacecraft. Inside the vessel, the Dragon Ball gang found the vacant ship to be strangely inviting, yet hiding some dangerous surprises. As the traps were sprung, it was Bulma who found herself caught in the noose. And Gohan and Krillin surrounded by a suspicious and angry mob.
Careful, men. Remember, they're ruthless.
Huh? Huh?
Hey, what have you done to Bulma? We're not your enemy, we're your friend. So why don't you just let her go?
Put a sock in it, Runt. I'm in command here.
I've got one thing to say. We're not your enemy, really. We come in peace. So why don't you put down your weapon and let's talk over a soda?
Eat laser.
Huh?
Ow, 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 ow.
Hey, come back here!
Don't move, huh? Chrome Dome. Or I'm gonna shoot again. They must be followers of the evil Frieza, so make sure the shot is a good one, Zeshin. Oh, I will. It'll be just like shooting fish in a barrel. Looks like checkmate. Game over. Hey, what's happening?
We're in big trouble, Zeshin! We're in the middle of an asteroid storm!
Oh, great! All right, men, it's up to you to keep an eye on these two. And if they even blink funny, shoot them!
gotcha!
Here, helpless, can we? Hurry up, we don't have much time.
Are you okay?
Good!
Rock, paper, scissors! Rock, paper, scissors! Rock, paper, scissors!
We're being captured by a bunch of goofballs.
Dragon Ball Z will return in a moment.
Says it all. Magoo, Mr. Magoo.
Virgo needs some backup.
Ladies man.
You know what I want? Give it to me.
You modern women.
Man's man.
It wouldn't last. I've never loved you.
Oh, man.
This Christmas, it's every man for himself. Leslie Nielsen is Mr. Magoo, the new name for cool. Rated PG. Starts Christmas Day.
You can't have great style if you've got damaged ends. The Vidal Sassoon Academy has news you can use. If your hair is thinner at the ends, you're losing protein. Vidal Sassoon shampoos and conditioners are a start to perfect ends with a protein moisturizer formula that's absorbed all the way to the ends to keep your style looking great. End of story.
I love happy endings.
Sassoon hair. Style that's perfectly you.
And with this disguise, I'll win the prize!
And now I'm racing for Tricks, a colorful part of this good breakfast!
For Tricks' bright fruity colors, I'll race for a taste. And for new Wildberry Blues, I've come in first place!
Blaze the Rabbit!
And Tricks with new Wildberries are still just for kids!
But they drive me wild!
You can collect Fashion Avenue Barbie figurines or special edition Hot Wheels cars. One car or figurine with two fruits from specially marked boxes.
We're the Breakfast Crew, and this is our new deal for breakfast. Everything will revolve around the toaster. All foods will be four-sided. And we'll have no use for spoons, except as nose guards. Naturally, the official food of the Breakfast Crew is anything but breakfast as usual. It's Kellogg's Pop-Tarts, funky frosting on top of real fruit filling, and side square pastry. Part of this complete breakfast, which if we had our way, would be self-rising. Because at breakfast, Pop-Tarts rule!
I heard Discovery Zone's got this excellent new Men in Black laser adventure. Save the Earth from the slime of the universe, and they'll make you an honorary MIB agent. There's this video wall, and birthdays are blasted easy. They're almost everywhere. Are you ready for the new DZ?
I am vengeance, vengeance, vengeance. I am the night, 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 the night.
Back at 6 and 6:30.
We won't be intimidated by criminal threats.
Every Saturday at 7, Cartoon Network is building you a better cartoon
Let's
show.
Let's do it!
Don't they look happy and content?
Blue flight, follow me.
We call it Toonami.
Let the fun begin!
I can feel the power surging through me.
Experiment is a combination of 30 years of dreams.
I could easily destroy all of you.
Take heed.
Saturday, 7 to 9.
Everyone off.
DLC now continues. Only Toonami.
Everything in control here?
Yeah.
Somebody help!
Come on, Gohan! You stay here.
Great. Now we're helping people who want to shoot us. Hey, Buster! This is no place to train! Shove over!
Hey, what are you doing?
What does it look like? I'm going to fly us out of here. Now, let's see how this baby works. There's the accelerator, and here's the ailerons, and there's the propulsion brakes. So let's just adjust the fuel ratio a bit, and... Stop gawking, soldier boy! You think you can do better?
No, I guess not.
Good. Settled then. Was a close one. Huh? Ah! Oh, not this again! Can't you get it through your heads that we're not your enemies?
You expect us to believe that?
Tell me why we should. You and your friends destroyed our planet.
Excuse me?
Bulma!
I think we have a little misunderstanding here.
Misunderstanding? No way! Only Frieza's none of that strong!
Who's this Frieza guy?
Got me.
I've heard as much from these Frieza followers as I'm going...
Fun.
Huh?
Session?
If they were loyal to Frieza, then why would they help us?
Maybe they're just trying to trick us into trusting them. Then when we're all asleep, they'll sneak up on us and who knows what they'll do.
Huh? I know. I remember when they came to our planet. The men of Frieza. Most evil force in the universe. They came to destroy everything and everyone that stood in their way. Including me. But creatures like that would never help us. Never. Kid, sorry I doubted you.
Bun.
These guys aren't with Frieza, Zeshin. I know now.
Man, Frieza's henchmen must be incredibly powerful. I hope this doesn't sound completely nuts, but did they have a monkey-like tail?
A tail? No, I didn't see any tail on them.
Then I guess they weren't Saiyans after all.
You seem to really dislike them. What did they do to you?
The planet that we come from was a beautiful and peaceful planet. Until they arrived. I remember the day they first arrived. They came with great force in the name of Frieza and destroyed everything so that the planet would be his to rule. It was horrible. Their numbers were far greater than ours. We had no chance against them. So we did the only thing we could do. We fled.
Gee, that just sounds horrible. So how did you escape?
Our engineers developed a mirror-like coating for the spaceship.
Huh?
Yeah.
That's why we appeared practically invisible to you.
Well, goodbye, guys! Sorry we gave you such a scare.
Sorry we didn't have more faith in you.
That's okay.
Oh.
it's Frieza.
No way. He just left. Maybe it's some unfriendly force, see?
Wait a second, looks like Vegeta! Come on!
Something's very wrong here. Now, why is it that we weren't informed about his arrival,
Attention!
Huh?
Attention! This is the control tower. Prepare for the arrival of Vegeta immediately!
I see it!
Huh? I see, only one. Where's Nappa?
What's he doing? How come he's not getting out of there?
If you were to ask me, he don't look so good.
What?
Look, he's hooked up to the Rejuvenator!
Come on, we gotta get him out of there into the treatment room, stat!
Your seatbelt, you guys. We might be in for a bit of a bumpy landing.
Yeah, right.
Get ready, because Planet Namek, here we come! Huh? Hooray! We made it!
Yes!
Wow! What's it look like? You think the Nameks are friendly?
Let's hope. You sure this is Namek?
You don't trust me?
Well...
Yes, I'm sure it's the planet Namek, you bean-headed bumble brain!
I guess that answers my question.
Is there anything else?
Well, we could check the dragon radar to be sure.
That's right!
Huh. Shows how much faith you have in me. What? Where am I?
Insta, she is awake.
Who are you?
He is the worst doctor on the entire planet.
And my comic sidekick here is Zacro.
Nice to meet you.
The pleasure is all ours.
This is how we say hello.
Oh.
Well then, it was very fortunate that we located you when we did. Because if we had not given you the proper medical treatment, you would not likely be with us now.
Thanks a lot. What about my two friends? Hey, you guys, come on, wake up.
Yeah?
Hi there.
Envista.
Happy thoughts.
Man, this is nuts.
Hang in there. We're here for a reason.
You're watching Dragon Ball Z.
So this is really Planet Namek?
Oh, yes.
I knew right off you were Nameks. I could tell by the way you look.
That's right. Why, they look just like Piccolo.
And the reason you have come... is the Dragon Balls.
Now, how'd you know?
Whoa!
Wow.
Well, let me just say that we have our ways. Upon your arrival, we put your ship in here.
Here we are!
Wow! Look at the size of this place!
Size isn't everything.
Look at our spaceship!
It looks pretty messed up. Do you think it'll still fly?
Oh, I think so!
Well, let me say this. I don't know how to thank you, but... well, thank you, guys!
Huh? Hey, look! A Dragon Ball! There's three, and they're really close.
What are we waiting for?
Let's go!
All right, jump in, boys.
Yeah!
Before you go, I must warn you to be careful out there, my friends.
What?
There are many monsters on our planet.
Monsters? Bulma?
Friends, just to be safe, I suggest that we take our ship. Well, everyone, according to my calculations, we should be close.
I think you're right. Very close. Just find a spot and set her down, okay?
All righty.
Not yet. We'll have another real good look, because that Dragon Ball has to be down there somewhere.
Nothing that looked like a Dragon Ball.
I didn't see anything either.
I found it!
Yeah!
A Dragon Ball!
Yay!
Get to it.
Out of here.
If my senses are correct, we should find another Dragon Ball in this ancient city.
Right again, Rady. It looks like there's one within 20 yards of where we're standing.
Hey, look, there!
What's that?
It looks like some kind of staircase.
And my signal gets stronger the closer I get to it.
Come, follow me.
Let's go.
This place gives me the willies.
I got a feeling something's down there that doesn't like kids.
Would you look at all the hieroglyphics? Oh.
Wow. Wow. Weird.
I can see that the stairs end soon.
Huh? Ah!
place.
Maybe this place is loaded with treasure. It's in here somewhere. Just a little farther.
Be careful! I have to say, that wasn't so difficult, was it?
As Bulma and the others track down the remaining Dragon Balls, what new challenge awaits them? Stay tuned for scenes from the next episode of Dragon Ball Z. On the next Dragon Ball Z, the gang tries to finish collecting the Dragon Balls, but it won't be easy. Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Enjoys championship excitement you can count on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's Give Me Five, the best of all five Bulls NBA championships, all on one video. Plus, this collector's dream, a commemorative Bulls basketball. Both the great video and the championship basketball are free with your paid gift subscription to Sports Illustrated, the best way to light up a sports fan every week. Your gift video puts him courtside with the champion Bulls so he can relive those marvelous memories from championships past. To treasure forever the greatness of those teams. And their unforgettable heroics. Give your favorite fan the thrills he wants. The best of the Bulls' five NBA championships. Plus, this Bulls Collector's Basketball commemorating the Bulls' five NBA championships. You can't get this limited edition Spalding ball anywhere else. It's the real deal, the official size and weight, so grab it before it's gone. And with Sports Illustrated, he'll receive an exciting new gift every week, all year long. This fine card will announce your gifts. Both great gifts are free with your order of 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.48 an issue. Save over 57% off the cover price. For the fastest delivery of your two free gifts, use your credit card and call now. Don't let them miss a memory.
Let the party begin.
One phone call gives them an unforgettable Bulls holiday gift pack. The great Bulls video and the commemorative Bulls basketball, both free from Sports Illustrated. Call now to make sure they get the best. Give Sports Illustrated. It's what they want.
For your listening pleasure, Toonami proudly broadcasts in full rich mono. Mono. Full rich mono. That is exactly the same signals of both channels of your monitoring system. Stereo is vastly overrated.
Got a guy, ran off a ledge. All right, sir, keep running, all right? But don't look down. You look down.
Yeah.
Well, now you're gonna fall. Sir, you're gonna make a hole in the ground in the shape of your body. Hopefully, you'll make an accordion noise. You're gonna be all right.
Welcome to Cartoon Network.
Screwy, ain't it?
Today at 5:30, Johnny Quest packs his bags.
What gives?
And Toonami goes to war.
We've got a full-scale Pred attack.
Open fire! For 1 week only. To your stations, quickly. Beast Wars, today at 5:30. Transformers 90s style. Only on Toonami.
Proximity alert. Proximity alert.
Flash.
What hidden terror keeps the Batman awake at night?
Bruce. Is there some past tragedy?
Bruce.
Why couldn't you save us, son?
I am vengeance.
I am the Knight. I am Batman.
Batman. Tonight, back to back at 6 and 6:30 on Cartoon Network. It's payback time.
We'll all become big kids and have the Earth as our toy.
Excellent. A signal from one of my Cyclopeds sentinels. It has obviously seen something. I shall zero in on the range of its itron beam. Aha! My Cyclopeds sentinel is accurate as usual. A strange craft has invaded my space domain.
How much longer, Jace?
A little bit more of this spray med, Jan, and the hole should be fixed. There you are, just about done.
Hurry it up, Jace. We're late now.
Okay, okay. Here, Blip, hold this a minute. Hey, watch it. That spray med hardens in space. Here, give me the gun.
How fortunate for me and unfortunate for those strangers. New creatures for my laboratory experiments. Cyclo to all Cyclo Sentinels. Initiate herding action into my maze of horror.
Jace, look what's coming! What are they? They're horrible!
Whatever they are, we'd better get out of here and fast.
But the ship's not fixed yet.
Quick, get out, Jan. There's no time to fix it now. Hit the power packs. Hurry, more speed.
Good, good. My cyclopeds are herding those creatures right into my maze.
Faster, Jan. They're closing in on us.
Let's hit the invisible button. Come on, let's do the same and...
No time. Those things are right behind us. Quick, into this tunnel.
Maybe they won't follow us in here.
Look out! Quick, this way. Back to the entrance.
That's strange. It's a solid wall now.
Come on, maybe it's over here.
No good, Jace. Another dead end.
It's a maze, Jan, and we've been trapped inside.
Exactly. Welcome to Cyclo's Maze of Horror. The maze is used to test reactions of inferior creatures, such as yourselves, to my super Cyclo Terror.
Oh, no!
It's a deep-armed nightmare. Keep close and keep flying, Jan.
I'm zeroing in on the space goop, all right. But I can't raise a reply from Jan and Jace. Wait a minute. There's the goop. I'd better investigate. It's empty. Blip! Where are Jan and Jace? Where, Blip? I get the message, all right. Jan and Jace are in danger. Somewhere down there. Stay here, Blip. I'm going down. Great Galaxy, what are those weird things?
You will soon find out what they are, Space Ghost. Cyclopeds, attack him. Attack, attack, attack.
Uh-oh, they mean business. I'll cool them off with my heat fork.
Before he destroys you all.
The rays have me locked in. I can't reach my power bands.
Very good, Cyclo Sentinels. Now bring Space Ghost to me.
Must reach my power bands. There. Now, my force field will take care of them. Now to find Jan and Jace. Space Ghost calling Jan and Jace. Come in if you hear me.
chase here, Space Ghost. We're trapped in the maze of horror.
And Space Ghost, hurry! There's a Cyclo Terror after us.
Hang on, I'm coming down.
We're really trapped now.
We've tried every corridor, and here comes the Cyclo Terror.
Our invisibility doesn't protect us from this monster.
Space Ghost!
Jen, Jace, get out. I'll take care of this monster. Wow! The heat force has no effect. I'll try my energy force. Blip, what are you doing here? Good work, Blip. The monster can't see a thing now.
Space Ghost will never get me.
Cyclo, come back here. Don't go into the maze. He forgot his own creation. The Cyclo Terror was in there. Things have a strange way of evening up, especially for poor, misguided creatures like Cyclo.
Woo-wee! This is one time I'm glad to be going home. Blip, I told you not to play with that.
It's all right, Jace. Blip did such a great job, he's entitled to a little fun with that spray mat.
All right, go ahead, have fun, Blip. You deserve it.
Is Toonami a failed experiment destined for destruction? For the first time ever, we want to hear what you think. Here's your shot to manipulate the manual. Drop us a line at Toonami, care of Cartoon Network, 1050 Techwood Drive, Atlanta, GA 30318. Thanks in advance.
Get set for the most incredible adventure videos you'll ever see.
Locomotion.
From the wilds of the western frontier, feel the power of giant locomotives hissing, steaming, boiling, blasting, thundering down the rails.
Locomotion.
Tires on fire, great clouds of thunder. Never has so much been recorded on two videotapes. Oilers, boilers, rods, and rails. Locomotion is guaranteed to keep you on the edge of your seat. Tunnels, trestles, snow-covered mountains. Locomotion rocks the rails in ground-pounding stereo. Not sold in stores, so get your credit card ready to order.
Locomotion.
Ride in the cab. Fire the engine side-by-side with the crew. Not ordinary home videos. Kids love them, too. Locomotion. Two big tapes, one low price. Immediate delivery, so call right now. Order toll-free, 1-800-441-2400, 800-441-2400, 1-800-441-2400.
If you haven't heard about the Big Comfy Couch, you will.
We want the Big Comfy Couch.
kids love the award-winning series The Big Comfy Couch from Time Life Kids, and their parents love it too.
Big Comfy Couch is the best show that's on the air right now for children.
The Big Comfy Couch gives your kids a great place to learn and grow.
Lunette and Molly are the favorite characters for my children.
I love Major Bedhead.
Package for Lunette!
I love the Dust Bunny.
The Dust Bunny lives under the couch.
That's very cute.
Call now and get your first video, honest to goodness, for the special introductory price of just $4.99. That's more than 60% off the regular price. If you like honest to goodness, other videos will arrive. Keep those you want. Cancel anytime.
It's a wonderful children's program.
Time Life Kids guarantees that your child will love the Big Comfy Couch the first time they watch it, or send it back for a complete refund. We'll even pay the postage. So don't wait for them to ask. Treat them to the Big Comfy Couch. Here's how to order.
To order your Big Comfy Couch, call 1-800-592-3388 or send $4.99 plus $3.49 shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
Right now from PBS, the folks who brought you Sesame Street and Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Adventures from the Book of Virtues, a new animated series that children and parents are going to love. And it's available now at a special two for the price of one offer. Follow the adventures of Zach and Annie as they have fun learning life's most important lessons, like honesty, compassion, and responsibility, with the help of some animal friends and classic adventure stories.
Father, I cannot tell a lie. I cut down the cherry tree with my hatchet.
Kids make fantastic discoveries in every exciting program. Call this toll-free number now. Have your credit card or check number ready to order the first video in this PBS series for only $12.95. When you do, we'll send you the second video free. That's two tapes for just $12.95. It's an incredible offer not available in retail stores.
I loved them.
Don't wait to take advantage of this special two for the price of one offer. Call now.
He is the brightest mind of his time. He is the creator of the world's most impressive laboratory. He is brilliant. He is inventive. He is afraid of being hit by a girl. He is Dexter. Dexter's Laboratory, tonight at 9 on Cartoon Network.
Heads up.
Brought to you by Home Alone 3. There's a new kid on the block.
Ouch.
Now playing only in theaters.
Ticket.
Uh-oh. Is it okay, Mommy?
Go ahead.
Come on in, Carrot Soup.
It's okay, honey. You can do it.
Yay! They are like Cabbage Patch Kids on the sea. Little splashing fun babies.
You did it.
Squirt the dolphin in the sea. The water cycles keep on splashing. You kids keep you laughing. Cabbage Patch splashing fun babies.
Dolls and vehicles move only with your help, each sold separately.
There's a one-of-a-kind Cabbage Patch Kid just for you.
Look of Arabia!
By Anthony Rank, age 8.
He called the doctor and said,
"Where's my milk?"
The doctor said, "I don't know."
"What do you mean?" "I saw your plane."
"You mean, where's my milk?"
"Your milk.
If it wasn't your plane, whose was it?"
Got milk.
Hidden dangers in daily life like pollution, chlorine, and UV rays can damage your hair, robbing it of its healthy shine. Fight back with Pantene Pro-V. It actually helps restore your hair's resilience. Pantene Pro-V. For hair so healthy, it shines. Give your hair a fighting chance.
Ticket.
On the next Real Adventures of Johnny Quest.
The Falcon, it cannot fly. These winds will blow it from the ledge. Ah, careful, Hodge! Okay, Jess, raise the well.
The Bangalore Falcon. Next time on the Real Adventures of Johnny Quest.
Hello, everybody. I'm Brad. Join me for Cartoon Network's New Year's Eve special. And all my friends who are out there at those fancy parties will be plenty jealous of me, boy. You better believe it. First, I got Scooby-Doo in Arabian Nights. Then you can watch Dexter. Then the big man Space Ghost in Coast to Coast. And Cartoon Planet. Don't I look pretty? New Year's Eve at 8. Party all night.
Hey, come here. What are you doing tonight around 8 o'clock? Because I got this show on Cartoon Network. Oh, yeah, the Cartoon Network. Sure, they love me. A little closer. Anyway, I was thinking we could do a little video dating.
Johnny Bravo, tonight at 8 on Cartoon Network.
Aw, can't we hire someone to do this kind of thing?
Transformers 90s style. The Beast Wars is coming up next on Toonami. To your stations, quickly.
A new specimen?
Dinobot, come on! You're supposed to be assisting!
Of course! Pardon my lack of enthusiasm for a bunch of worthless weeds. You realize that we are targets out here. Targets! And still, you stop to smell the roses. Or whatever.
Dinobot, I signed on for this mission as an explorer. Just because we bumped into Predacons is no reason to stop learning new things.
Well, if we encounter any of Megatron's forces, you may learn that it is unwise to dally with plants. We should be devising battle strategies.
Knowledge of the territory can be an advantage in battle, Dinobot. You're a soldier, you should know that.
I somehow doubt this plant will be a turning point. But very well, if have it you must, stand aside. I'll blast it out. Dinobot, Maxim!
Hold on. Hold on! You see? It is possible to look for non-violent solutions first.
Perhaps. But I think you've lost your battle edge, Optimus. In our fight against Megatron, there is nothing you can learn from this worthless weed. Get this thing off me! I can't reach it! Get it off!
Hold on! Hold on! Got you right in the one place you can't reach, didn't it? You see? That's how it spreads its seed. We've learned something.
Yes. From now on, I shoot my dinner salad before I eat it.
We'll need to find another specimen.
How about an arachnid?
Optimus, maximize!
I know what. Maximize!
A special cyber bee just for you, Optimus Primal. Enjoy!
supposed to be his backup.
We were ambushed, and don't tell me my duty, Furball, or you shall soon be occupying several recycling bins.
Wanna try it now, Lizard Lips?
Hey, as much as I'd love to see the both of you scrap yourselves, save it for my birthday. Right now, we got bigger concerns. Rhinox, what's the sitch?
Looks like a viral mind. It's fused with his net core. He can't transform while the thing's attached.
Well, then let's get it off. He took enough energon damage just getting back here.
Can't be done. The mind's rerouted all his life support functions to itself. We yank it. He lives for less than a minute.
Whoa, that's bad.
Gets worse. Right after that, the mine explodes, taking out everyone within sprinting distance.
Man, I don't get it. Why? For what?
A viral mine, you say? I know Scorponok's creations. This one is intended to turn our leader into a coward, one who will lead us to defeat. Only Scorponok will have the antivirus.
There's gotta be a way to put the skids on. Huh? All right. Who wants some? Nobody takes it off. Understand? You hear me? I'll blow your slagging heads off!
No, Big Bot!
Hold on there! Get off of me!
Yes. Listen to him.
I don't fear you. I don't fear any of you! I thought that thing was supposed to turn him into a coward.
No doubt that was its intention. But Scorponok is notoriously incompetent. I would say instead that we have a berserker. Interesting.
Optimus can beat it! Come on, Big Bot, fight against it! You can do it! Please.
It's too much. I can't fight it. Disarm my weapons. Lock me up.
Scorponok. Yes, I've been waiting for your report.
I stuck it to a Megatron. And good!
Excellent. And the antivirus?
Just one! Like you said, right behind you.
By now, Optimus Primal has most assuredly exchanged his courage for a nice, cowardly yellow stripe. Yes, but he will not want to stay that way. No. So when he leads his misguided mechanoids on a futile raid for this antivirus, it will be their final battle in the Beast Wars.
What do you want? Cheetor, I'm sorry. It's hard to control.
Is there any of the old Optimus left?
Yes, some.
Don't let it go, Big Bot. Don't let this thing tweak you out of control.
I don't know if I can beat it, but I think I can adapt to it. Maybe hold this aggression down, even use it to our advantage.
Really? Well, I knew it! You ain't too tough to be dropped by any techno flu. Let's do it!
What do you mean, use it to our advantage?
Up Optimus is a war machine. I say we point him in the right direction, give him full armament, and then unleash him upon the Predacons. If we want the antivirus, that is the only way to get it.
Hey! Yeah, normally I would love to see the Preds get their little scheme tossed right back at them, but you're forgetting just one little thing.
And that would be...
Optimus would get blown to scrap. Big problem.
Well, that depends on your viewpoint.
Hey, shut up!
Actually, that's not a bad idea.
Cheetor, what have you done?
It's gonna be okay. Optimus has got it under his thumb. Tell him, Big Bot.
I think I can do this. By channeling this new fighting instinct, we can storm their base and, with your help, obtain the antivirus.
Yeah, piece of basic programming. We blast our way into Scorponok's lab for the antivirus. All we want is to get Big Bot here back to normal.
Yeah? And, what if he goes ape slag on us?
Fine by me.
Hey, they made me what I am today. So I figure it's time to say thank you. Now! Yeah!
Before he hurts himself.
Him? Try us!
Keep his arm down!
Watch that laser!
You don't understand. Like Dinobot says, we gotta hit the Preds the only way they understand. Hard, fast, and right where it hurts. But if your caution circuits are overriding your courage, let's melt you all. I don't need you. I'll handle this myself.
Toonami will return in a moment.
Hi, I'm Joy Mangano, and this is my Rolly Kit. It's the compact, high-tech storage system that rolls up and rolls out and displays everything at your fingertips, and now a Rolly Kit just for kids and their toys. My kids call it the Rolly Poly.
I use it for my little boy's toys. When he wants to play with them, I just pull them out and let him go for it.
Even if you shake it up, toss it around, nothing gets out of place. It gets all those little pieces and parts off the floor. You'll love it, and kids love it too, because it's fun and it's their place for their stuff.
Yeah, I have three sons that are in Scouts, and everything that they get, it's all here.
You and your kids will be so happy if you call today and get your Rolly Kit, or should I say Rolly Poly. It's just $19.95. So call now.
Have your credit card ready and call 1-800-441-2400. The Rolly Kit just for kids is $19.95. Call 1-800-441-2400. That's 1-800-441-2400. Call now.
Can you tell the difference between these contact lenses? They're the same brand, same prescription, but this lens cost 50% less and was delivered right to my home. That's the Lens Express difference.
Save on brand name contacts, daily wear, extended wear, disposables, and others.
I wouldn't trust these baby blues to just anyone. Call Lens Express. They're terrific.
Now you can replace your contacts and save. Call for a free Lens Express catalog.
You know, I'm walking this way to pick up great-tasting Malt-O-Meal cereals. Yet some people still haven't tried it because it comes in a bag. But guess what? All these cereals come in bags. Now that you can't see the difference, we bet that you can't taste the difference either. Because Malt-O-Meal tastes every bit as good as the leading brands. See? And costs a lot less. So, bag the box. You really ought to come down here.
Monster Trapping by William Kern, age 8 and a half. Today we will show you how to trap a monster stealing your milk. When he comes into your kitchen, he'll step on a small red button. Make that button give a force field around the milk in the refrigerator. Also, make that button turn on a video camera so you can know what he looks like. The force field will freeze him in place and you can take him to monster jail. If that will not work, you can jump in a 1968 Camaro. Got milk.
Are we ready to say goodbye to 1997? Are you ready, New York City? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
The year of Godzilla.
You put your heart in, you take your apathy out. You put your heart in and you shake it all about. Distribute all donations to the families that need it most. And that's what it's all about. United Way! You put your love in, you take your greedy indulgent self out. You put your love in and you shake it all about. You do the right thing because you're a decent human being and never know when you might need help yourself. And that's what it's all about. United Way!
At Turner Classic Movies, we show more movies than any other channel, always uncolorized and commercial-free. No wonder it's called Movie Heaven. So call your cable operator and tell them you want Turner Classic Movies. Truly, Movie Heaven.
The Super Legion of Doom. Upholding evil. Justice and peace for all humankind. Wonder Woman. Aquaman. Super.
Solomon Grundy. Grodd. Lex Luthor. Masters
of Truth. The Legion of Doom. And the Superfans. Struggling for superiority. Tonight at 6 on Cartoon Network.
Dust. Fury is not yet complete. Your patience is appreciated as we come to speed. See this space for further details. Thank you.
Now it's time for us to alter history.
This is not the way, Cheetor.
We gotta back him up!
It is a doomed mission. There's no strategy, just blind aggression.
Well, maybe that's what we've been needing. A little less brain and a little more guts.
We must try to think what Optimus, the old Optimus, would do.
And that would be...
negotiate. Got a maximal tight beam transmission coming in. It's a little garbled by the energon fields, but...
Bring it up, yes.
Predacon base, come in!
Pussycat, yes. State your business.
Listen up, you miswired metalheads. You botched up your little attitude adjustment on Optimus. He's flaming towards you on the Red Eye Express, and he's loaded for mainframe combat. So what do you say you fork over that antivirus before you get vaped?
Any renegade Maximal who blunders into our base will not survive. Megatron out. Incompetent bug.
Beast mode.
Well?
It didn't work. All we did was tip them off, and now they're gonna be waiting for him. You and your bright ideas.
It would appear that only Optimus can truly think like Optimus. For the rest of us, we must now think on our own.
Hey,
hull has been breached.
Tarantulas, destroy the intruder.
Are coming.
Take Pterosaur and defend the perimeter. Waspinator, stop Optimus now.
Waspinator, get him!
Warfare suits you. The old Optimus would have never made it this far.
What is it you want?
Your allegiance in exchange for this antivirus. Yes.
And if I refuse?
You cannot refuse. No, not if you want to survive. Join me or perish.
Why not end this here and now, Megatron?
You fool! You destroy us all!
Just a little trick I learned from a flower, Megatron!
Big Bot! Got the antivirus right here! Yes! We're online! Let's bail before that thing blows!
Get this thing off of me! Now!
Time to fade, heroes!
Bedside vigil, Dinobot? Not like you.
It was my shift.
It's good to have you back.
Back home? Or back to normal?
Both.
Protect your child from needless injury in an automobile accident. All children outgrow their car safety seats but may still be too small for seatbelts designed for grown-ups. And when seatbelts are uncomfortable, kids don't wear them properly, creating the potential for danger. The answer? SafeFit, an award-winning product designed to adjust your child's seatbelt so it's worn safely and comfortably. SafeFit just slips onto the seatbelt and directs it over the shoulder rather than across the neck of your child. This crash test shows what happens in a head-on collision. The dummy in the background wears the seatbelt incorrectly, while the dummy in the foreground is properly restrained with SafeFit. Help your child get in the habit of buckling up properly. It's a habit that will last a lifetime.
Call 1-800-634-7222 and receive your SafeFit for just $14.95 plus shipping with a full 90-day money-back guarantee. That's 1-800-634-7222, or send check or money order to the address on your screen. Order now.
Oh,